I wanted to try something new and different. We only live once, right? So here we are. Welcome back to my channel. I upload on Mondays, Thursdays, and Fridays, but a little thing about me is I also like to do surprise uploads. Join the party if you will. All you have to do is click that subscribe button to get notified. And if you have already subscribed, thank you. I greatly do appreciate it. Got another wig to review for you today, and she is also a new drop. I will give you all of the important information about her. If you feel I left something out, though, just tell me. And also, give me your respectful feedback down in the comments. And if there's a wig you'd like me to review, just let me know. Who I've got for you today is Mayde Beauty in the style BRINA. She is a full cap wig from the Candy Wig Collection. I have her in the color TH4826. And that is this color right here. She doesn't come in all too many colors, but a lot of them are pretty. They even show a few of them here on the stock card, which is nice. She is heat safe up to 400 degrees Fahrenheit, and I picked her up from wigtypes for $21.94. This is BRINA right out of the box. So since there's no lace to look at, she's got bangs. It's been a while since I've reviewed a full banged wig. Let's flip her inside out, see what's going on. Really nice breathable type mesh lining. I like this kind, but she has absolutely no combs. Zilch. Nada. Zero. None. But she does have adjustable straps, and stretchability is actually really nice. So there's a high probability that she will be larger head friendly. Let me go put her on and be right back with my final thoughts. All right, guys, I'm back with BRINA. It's like a culture shock seeing myself with bangs. It's been a lot of years. I know that they are coming back in style. They just never really were quite my thing. So it's just really unusual seeing myself with them right now. But I wanted to try something new and different. We only live once, right? So here we are. If you are looking for a quick plop on your head and go type of girl, that is what she is. Obviously, you don't have to worry about any lace to be cut or doing any blending. She's very easy peasy, and I do love that. The only thing you might run into is having to get the bangs just right. I found them to be a little bit too long, so I trimmed just a tiny little bit. Not so much that it was very noticeable, because if you do try to pull her back, obviously, then you're going to have that wig cap shine through. So just be cautious of that. Therefore, you might need to do a little trimming, or you could style her differently, like part her in the center or something with the bangs. That's always an option as well. So at least you have a little bit of versatility, and that I also do like. This color, though, let's talk about that. Ooh. This top highlight is a color type that we don't see all that often, so I'm glad that she's got this. I think it's very pretty. I like it a lot. You've got the 26 here on top, very beautiful golden tones. And then you have the darker layer underneath. And that is what you see up here in the root area. So I think that this looks professional and very pretty. So I do think that they did a good job with the blending and stuff. Really nice color and also really good luster. Looks like natural, healthy hair in my opinion. This texture, it's more of a yakky. It's very soft. It feels realistic. And this is also the type of texture that those that prefer light yakky or silky units will probably still like. Therefore, I think that she is a really good multicultural unit. As far as a length goes, that's not bad either. About 22 inches. Little bit of layering right here, not all that much though. I think this is a really good manageable length for this particular style. She's got really good density, so there's not much to her. She's very simple, and I'm not getting much for tangles at all. I also am not having to grab a brush or a comb. I'm finding that just using my fingers is sufficient for tidying her up. And that is why I mentioned she's really easy to manage. So if you are somebody that is on the go a lot or looking for a good work wig, I do recommend her for those. Let's take a look at her from the back. All right, I haven't noticed anything excessive as far as shedding goes either. I know this type of color does tend to shed a little bit more, but I haven't noticed anything that I am worried about with that. And she doesn't have any parting space, nothing up there to have to worry about blending or anything. You know how sometimes these types of units will have a little tiny spot on the top? I don't even see that. So in my opinion, I like this better. I think it looks more natural and, again, easy to take care of. So I really do like it. I actually like this wig. She's really comfortable, too. I was worried at first about the not having any combs, but now that I have her on, she's pretty secure without that. All I had to do was just use the adjustable straps, but if you are really concerned about it, a wig grip should be sufficient to keep her in place. And I do think she is larger head friendly as well, therefore she is perfect for everybody. I really like this wig, even though I'm not still sure if I like the bangs on me, but I think this is a really good wig, and especially for somebody that wants a quick wig to put together and for easy to manage throughout the day, and also one that just likes bangs, well, there you go. I think she's a really good option. I'm even tempted to get her in this color too. I did have a hard time deciding between the two colors, to be honest with you. So now that I have her in this one, I think I just might, especially since she's only $22 before shipping. That's not bad at all. That is what I gotta say about Brina. She's thumbs up. Give me your thoughts down in the comments, and also let me know if you got her or if you plan to get her after watching this review. That's all I got for her today. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll just catch you all in my next video, and until next time, bye-bye.